Hello YouTube, and welcome to my second tutorial video. The previous video was we were importing and arranging images. Today we'll be looking at actually setting up the bone structure for our animations. So to start off, we've got our images obviously set up, and on our draw order we can see them all properly allocated. Additionally, what we'll be doing is switching over to the scene panorama then, and from this we will be able to sign up on structures and make sure the correct image is assigned to the correct bone. To start off, we've got to start at the very base. Obviously, it's going to be the body in this case, the small body, and maybe the pants as well, which will host all the various other bones, because all of them will be linked to the specific one. Obviously, that one is linked, or the first bone will be linked to this little circle at the bottom, our root bone structure, if we could call it that. Now, the tools available, if we look at the top there, the top right of our drawing area, we've got a few commands there. It's select, pose, create bone, weight, and also got, let's actually sort of the zoom. But what we'll start here is create bone, which is actually our bone shortcut key, R. Now, as soon as we hit R, it will actually start with that command. Oh, sorry, not R, E. We'll start the command then. We can see our cursor, but there's a little badge there, let's add a bone structure. So let's start here. I'm just going to drag a bone there, which will be the main bone at the back, or the body, or so to say. And immediately once it's created, if it actually picked up the relevant images, it would have added to that bone structure. Now it did not do that, so what I'm going to do is going to rename this bone. I'm going to call this body, and I'm going to grab my pants and my body, simply drag it down that attaches to the bone structure. Now immediately, if I select that bone structure and I rotate it, we can see it rotates those images specifically. So I'm just going to control Z to undo that. I'm going to pick this bone. Very important to pick the bone you're working from, and then add the consequent or the preceding bone structures. In this case, it's going to be for the torso here. And we can see it actually picked it up immediately as torso, with the image torso as well. So I can actually carry on from that. Torso is the next one, and from that I'll start my arms. Carrying on, it's still selected, so I can just carry on with that. And we've got right arm, perfectly done. Okay, so I'm going to select my torso again, recreate it with the command key E if I wanted to, and just place it in the next few arms. And that has successfully worked as well. It's quite pleasing, because it doesn't always work that nice. I'm going to head back to my torso again and link up my I don't know if I want to do my neck and my head in one bone. Ugh, let's do it. It's going to be a few of them though. It's not just going to be neck and head. I'm going to add the head on well, because I'm planning on adding onto this hair a mesh, so I can actually make it like bounce, if I could say it like that. Now, just using the select tool there, which is Q, we have hair left only. So I'm going to rename this. I'm going to call this head. And on this head, I'm going to add, obviously, that image, the hair, my neck, back hair is already assigned there, no one specifically like that. Okay, well, that seems like it's generic. Okay, so for back hair left, head, and neck, it seems to be all of the ones I need to cover. I'm going to move on from the head, add my little tiny ear, and again for the other ear. And I can see already, as I'm picking it down, as I'm creating this bone, you'll see it creates a little box around the image. That is the image that assigns to that particular bone. You can see this ear left and ear right, perfectly created. I can move back to the bottom there, which is my body. Pick that as my starting point, and then maybe add it for my right leg upper and right leg lower, and that seems to have done the trick. So again, do that one on that upper leg and on that lower leg. Thank you. I've got to learn to start using the shortcut keys. It's going to help me in the long run. And just testing it out. Let's see. Oop, this one forgotten. Which is here, right? And I gotta head on, add it on the bone structure. Obviously, moved it as I shouldn't have. Because everything has been attached to that bone. So let's test it out. Next thing is to be working, although I have to move it up a little bit to make it fit. Make the line work a little bit better. Obviously, the easiest thing. I have to play around a bit, it's not going to work so like on that. So, I'm going to move this pivot point down, move this one a little bit up, move that one back, and let's test. Seems to be much better. That should do. Okay, the other leg. Again, let's drop it down. That image up. Move it up. That should. Nope. That should be fine. It's just there's legs here. You see they're slightly off. A little, and that should be fine. Just a little, perfect. This one, oh, that's way off, way, way off. Go, maybe consider moving that rotor point to. That point yeah, a little bit better, and that should be perfect. The best, really too happy about this. Seems to be in working order. Let's check out the arms. A little bit movement needed there. And good. Seems to be working fine. Screw it up a little bit. Doesn't look so lucky now, but obviously, once the animations gets going, it should be A, O, K. Good. And that seems to be working nicely. Make it kick up. Well, I think in the head a little bit, that's nice. Yes, not too much rotation there. I'll figure them out a bit later, I'm not going to worry about it too much now. Obviously, if I rotate this main body here, you can see the whole body rotates. So yeah, the hips and the main body is probably going to stay the same. I can probably make or sort of make them stand out by doing some sort of meshing on this body for breathing. The hair for obviously volume. Yeah. Okay. Looking at this, you can see if I close the body there, my scene, it actually closes all of them. Legs, also hides the rest of them. So you can close them if you want to. I like to keep them open, not that I'm going to use this much anyway. It's just to see what's going on into my build here. You can change this draw order anytime you like. It's going to change your design completely, so just be aware of that. And then, yeah, that's all I've got to do for this video. Thank you for joining. I hope you guys liked it. Please subscribe and like this video. And tune in for the next one.